Hi, in today master camp we are going to see how to do machining of face mill. Okay, in this I am just going with the wireframe and selecting a rectangular and giving design here. 120 mm length and height will be around 70 mm. Okay, done, and going to view and setting the fit. Okay, next going to solids and defining the wireframe entity and giving 50 mm extrusion and completed. And now we are going to machine. And in machine the milling, we are going for third axis and going to properties and giving files name, facing, and in tool settings I am just giving program number. The feed calculation is to be calculated from the material spec. Okay, and in tool path configuration I'm just giving assigning tool number sequence and one of duplicate tool numbers and use tool steps and picks. Okay, and search tool library and the sequence number to be in increment. Okay, and I'm just leaving as I required aluminium 2024 as a material and going to stock setup. In stock setup I'm just using a rectangular bar. So after selection of rectangular bar I am just giving all solids and I am just adding the final stock of 52 mm. Okay, done. Now the stock has been increased and we are going for in tool paths menu, and in tool paths menu we are going to 2D and we are going to do face, that is the facing operation, and in this we have to select wireframe or solids based on the your model you can select it. I'm just using wireframe and going to select the entity, and if you not enabled the chain you have to, it will be in select like this options. Okay, I will show you how. Okay, if you see if it's not in chain you will only the one entity will be selected. If it is in chain, okay, I will show you. If you just click any one line it will be totally selected. Okay, and I select the chain option and go, and this is the 2D facing tool path controlling bar controlling options. In that there are a tool path style, I'm just selecting it will be as it is facing. Okay, and the tool I'm just going to select from tool library as 55 mm and going with the holder of default and cut parameters. In this we are going in the cut parameters there are four styles: zigzag, one way and one pass and dynamic. In this we will see in this all the styles in upcoming steps. Okay, I am just first giving zigzag and I'm just controlling the overlap as 90%, and along overlap also 90%, and approach distance I am just reducing to 15%, and exit distance also I am just giving 15%, and the step over of each first pass and second pass will be around 75% of tool contributions. That means 41.25 mm will be step over from first to second. and I just giving auto's angle, and this will give the shortened toolpaths. Okay, these are the things which we have carried up our side is to control the short toolpaths and to resist the unwanted movement of machine. Okay, in depth of cuts I am just giving 0.5, and from in this is in linking parameter which the stock has to be which is the stock and machining linking parameters. I just giving top of the stock, just selected, and absolutely I am 2 mm, I am just gear, because from that face it will be 2 mm stock is available. So why, and the depth just click same, because that is the face I require. Okay, from home position to be taken from the machine, so I just click here and going to the plane setup. And in plane setup there are three things: one is work coordinate system, tools plane, and construction plane. The work coordinate system is the main thing which is to be same as per the master cam and in the machine. So I just click that and giving the work coordinate system, and the tool plane also can be same, and the construction plane also being the same based on the component geometry. And next the coolant. In coolant I am just going to flood option on, because it's a face mill, so it's required flood option, because a high material removal rate will be carried. To cool the tool we will go with the flood, and then okay. If you see, the tool path has been generated. Okay, to change anything in this tool path we can go to parameter, to control I am just giving 40%, or you can just give one. See, now it is very shortened toolpath. Okay, it is also accepted. Its cycle time, let's go and see. Cycle time is 1 minute and 10 seconds. Okay, but if you see, it does not cover this areas and this areas and this area, so we have to modify a little bit. I'm just giving as 10 and 10 and 20 and 20. If you check out, see, and the cycle time will be 1 minute and 31 seconds. Okay, this is the zigzag option, zigzag style. Okay, now because the finishing stock is I think 1 mm, so if you give 0 finish pass, it will be around 4 passes, and the cycle time will be increased. If you see, it is 3 minute and 2 seconds. Okay, and I will just copy and paste. Okay, same toolpath will be coming here, and I am just going to parameter. I am just changing the one way, and remaining all the things are will be same. Okay, and just giving generate, and let's go there, see how the cycle time is. It is 3 minute and 17 seconds. Okay, if you enabled this, the old, see, it is the, if you see, this is the first toolpath and this is the second toolpath. Okay, it is one way toolpath, Okay, next tool path, let's go and as it is copy and paste, and I'm just going with one pass, and in this which the width of that tool to be used, so we have to go with the 80 mm face mail. Okay, and see, because the 55 mm, the what is the width of this block, the cutter to be extended from that requirement, so it is 70 mm, so I'm just going with the 80 mm face mill cutter, so it is only one, it will be in single line of tool path, and if you see the, it will be covered or most of, see, that's it. Okay, the cycle time will be 1 minute and 36 seconds. Okay, and I'm just copying and pasting the same, okay, of one way, and I'm just going with the dynamic, and the dynamic which will be the contoured toolpath, if you see here, it will be self-explanatory. Okay, in this, what is the parameters and so on, so we are using 55 mm same tool for this, and if you see the cycle time, it will be 6 minutes and 43 seconds. Okay, by using, we can control it, approach distance, we can go with 80% of it, top set, all other things remain same, so I'm trying to reduce the cycle time, I think it's not possible, same cycle time. So based on this, either I recommend you can use first option, zigzag option, or you can go with the third option. It is a one-way mill, sorry, one-pass mill. It is a one-pass tail. Okay, and okay, we will see all these tool paths in verify option by using. Yeah, let's go to isometric view and verify, and collision checks will be honored, and remove chips. Okay, then see, if you see here, the only last pass, last dynamic is so high cycle time. Okay, and I will just initial stop. Okay, and we will run it. Once again, I am showing it to you in this video. Okay, and this is the comparison. Oh, workpiece and the stock. Okay, it's finished. Okay, if you see the red and gray, the gray color which is a workpiece and the stock. Okay, so and we will go to mission and go with the generate of post, which the program generation, and we just give where the files to be. I'm just giving facing the program is generated. See the date and month here, the time and the location of the mastercam file and the location of the NC file and material used, tools involved in the program lines will be starting. This takes around 916 line, because we have selected all these options. If you want to select specifically require only first option program, you see it's another one area to generate the program, which is same G1, and if you click here poster, and you can give facing JIT push, facing JIT which the, I have given short name. This is the program, which is around 40 lines, okay, for the machining. There is only one tool which is involved for this option, and this is the times and what is the material, so and so things are available in it. Okay, thank you.